With my infrastructure resources in place, it's time to provision an Oracle Database Cloud Service instance. I must have this service in place before I can create a Java Cloud Service instance. Before getting started, I need to make sure I have available the following information from the infrastructure resources: the availability domain, the subnet from the VCN that I created in Oracle Cloud Infrastructure, the object storage bucket name, the Swift password, and the region I created with my Oracle Cloud Infrastructure resources. Using my Oracle Cloud credentials, I'll log into the My Services dashboard. From the Action menu for my Database Cloud Service account, I'll select Open Service Console, and on the Service Console, launch the Provisioning Wizard by clicking Create Service. First, on the Basic Service Information page, I'll give my database instance a name. Then, I'll select the same region in which I created the Oracle Cloud Infrastructure resources earlier. Selecting the region spawns two additional required fields, the availability domain and the subnet. I'll select values for these fields based on the information I recorded while creating the infrastructure resources. Since I want to use the default values for the rest of the subscription details, I'll click Next and move on to the Service Details page, where I'll enter critical information about my service. First, I'll create and confirm an administration password, which I can use when I need to access the Database Administration Console. Then, I'll select a compute shape that will meet my load and processing requirements. My options will include only the Oracle Cloud Infrastructure compute shapes. Next, I'll insert an SSH public key, which provides authentication when connecting to a node in my instance through a secure shell client. I'll click Edit to open the Public Key Access for VM dialog box, and here, click Choose File to open my local file system. I'll select a public key, and then click Open. Now, I'll click Enter, and the public key has been inserted. Next, I'll ensure I'm using both cloud storage and local storage for any backups. For my cloud storage container, I'll enter the URL for the object storage bucket I created as one of my infrastructure resources. This can be a rather long entry since I need to enter the full URL in this fixed format. The variables in this format are the region, tenant, and bucket. This is why I made sure to copy the name after I created the bucket. Now, I'll enter the username and the Swift password I generated earlier, and then accept the remaining defaults and click Next. I'll verify the details of my service, paying particular attention to the compute shape, region, availability domain, subnet, and the storage configuration. These all look fine, so I'll click Create. As it's being prepared, my new service will appear in the Database Cloud Service console. I can track provisioning progress here in the Service Create and Delete History panel, simply by clicking Detail. And I can see that my service instance has been successfully provisioned. Now, I can go to the overview page for my service and see more details about it. Thank you for watching Creating a Database Cloud Service Deployment on Oracle Cloud Infrastructure. Now that I've created a Database Cloud Service deployment, I can use it to create a Java Cloud Service instance. To see a demonstration of this task, I invite you to watch Creating a Java Cloud Service Instance on Oracle Cloud Infrastructure. And for more information about Oracle Cloud Infrastructure, please visit us online.